Are you wondering what happens during an ear tube surgery and how to care for your little one after the procedure? Well, in this video, I'm gonna share with you what you need to know during the procedure and after procedure as a parent. Hi, I'm Josephine and I'm a registered nurse, and I've worked in surgery preparing patients and parents on what they need to know before, during, and after an ear tube surgery. If you are new to my community, I help educate new moms on the journey to pregnancy and motherhood and hopefully inspire you to be the best mom you can be. Now, if you haven't seen the first part of this video series, I talk about what you need to know before the procedure. So make sure that you click here and then come back and watch this video. Once you finish everything before the procedure, the surgery nurse will come and visit with you and carry your baby to the operating room. The baby will be in the operating room for maybe 10 to 15 minutes. It's very quick and very fast. Your baby gets put to sleep for the procedure by anesthesia gas. And you as a parent will stay in the room where your baby got ready for the procedure. Now remember, you signed a form that says during the surgery, you will stay on the unit. So just remember, as they get wheeled to the operating room, you cannot go down to the vending machine, you can't go to the cafeteria, you can't go off the unit in case of an emergency. The time that it takes your baby to go to the operating room and come back to where you are is roughly gonna be about 45 minutes. Now, once the doctor is done with the procedure, he or she will come out and meet you in that room to give you an update on how the procedure went. After the procedure is done, your baby will be taken to the recovery room where they will stay there for about 30 minutes. And this is where we as nurses will get vital signs such as heart rate, blood pressure, oxygen saturation, and wake up the baby if they're still sleeping. We'll do a pain assessment to make sure that they are not in pain. The child specialist that you saw before the procedure will also be waiting in PACU or recovery room for when your baby arrives. He or she will help in any way possible. If you're getting value from this content, make sure you like the video and subscribe to my channel. Once the baby is awake and their vital signs look good, we will go ahead and carry them out to where you are at. Now, when the nurse is carrying them from recovery room to where you are located, they may be crying, don't be alarmed. That's a normal response, usually with kids. And when your baby arrives, this is the best time for you to breastfeed, give them formula, or give them something that is familiar to them. This is where we can give them juice, we can give them a popsicle if they want it. We will also get a set of vital signs while you're holding your baby to make sure that everything looks okay. If they're screaming when they come to you and it's unrelieved by feeding, then we can go ahead and give them something for pain. And this is where we start the discharge process and give you your discharge instructions. Now, every doctor is different, so your discharge instructions may differ from these. Always refer to what your ENT doctor says. But some common discharge instructions that you will see are: continue with your ear drops if prescribed by the doctor, monitor for excessive draining from the ear, such as a soaked pillow when they sleep, any yellow-green drainage, foul-smelling odor coming out of the ear. If you see any of those signs, call your doctor. Temperature of 101 or greater, call your doctor. Your baby can start their regular diet. There's no diet restrictions. Make a post-op appointment with your ENT surgeon 2 to 4 weeks from the surgery date or directed by your doctor. And try to keep the ear dry. Some doctors will recommend you put cotton swabs while they're bathing, or buy a wax mold to put while they're bathing or if they're gonna be in water. And monitor for any small tubes that may come out of the ear. As always, remember, it's always a great day to grow. I will see you guys in the next video.